on the hot button issue of education, we're tracking teacher shortages in Arizona. In 2017, Arizona School Personnel Administrators Association found there were 8,595 total teacher openings. A survey just 1 year later showed that not much has changed, as Cronkite News reporter Imani Stevens found out.
178 Arizona school districts and charter schools responded to the survey. And as of the end of August, there were a little over 6,000 teacher openings needed to be filled for the school year.
What we've seen is the continuation of the problem that we have in the state of Arizona, which is we simply cannot find teachers to fill the positions we have.
Jill Gonzalez, an analyst with Wallet Hub, says in their 2018 report of the best and worst states to teach in, Arizona ranked close to last with a spot just before Hawaii.
And that really has to do with falling short in pretty much every one of these metrics.
The report analyzed different metrics to rank each state.
By looking at 22 different indicators of teacher friendliness, everything from income growth potential to the change in teacher salaries over the past decade or so, to pupil-to-teacher ratio.
Those metrics listed Arizona at 46 for the highest projected teacher turnover and at 50th for the highest pupil-to-teacher ratio. School districts in the state have looked to other states and outside of the U.S. to fulfill these positions. But Ryan Saunders of the Learning Policy Institute says that's not always effective.
What we've found, though, is that that contributes to shortages long-term. If you have underqualified or uncertified people in the profession, they aren't going to stay in teaching long term. They're 2 to 3 times more likely to leave.
And the ASPAA survey showed that there were close to 3,000 people who did not meet the standard teacher requirements to fill teacher positions.
If we want to ensure that our kids receive the best education possible, then we need to ensure that they have high quality teachers in every single one of their classes.
In Washington, Imani Stevens, Cronkite News.